because they are filled with amazing creatures like orcas here in the Pacific Northwest. And healthy seas have the potential to provide a billion people with a seafood meal each day. Visit oceana.org to sign up. Let's save the oceans and feed the world.
You've been working hard for years, and now you have your big chance. But the expense of training, travel, and competition have put your dream out of reach. Now, there's a way for all your family, friends, and fans to help you achieve your goal. RallyMe Expand empowers the global sports community. Start raising money today.
In life, if you're doing something that both excites you and scares you,
it is the Mountain Report. My name is Greg Powers, living the dream on this vacation week, and I hope you are all enjoying your vacation week with many activities to enjoy and more to come throughout the week. We'll bring you that information this morning. We start off the day with 27 degrees, 149 trails, 50 of those are groomed out, and we're rocking to the Mallet Brothers, who will be where? At the Widowmaker, and they will be there tomorrow night, and you'll want to definitely go check that out. The Mallet Brothers coming to Sugarloaf at the Widowmaker and try their halfway to reggae beer. We are going to take a look at our weather and trail conditions. Keith, what do you got on tap over there at the weather desk?
Oh, we've got all kinds of fun stuff.
Good morning to you, sir.
Good morning.
Let's take a look at our weather and trail conditions on the mountain.
Weather Report is brought to you by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
The WSKI TV 17 Weather Report is brought to you by the Widowmaker. Find them upstairs in the base lodge.
Good morning, all you skiers, riders, and shredders out there. And this is your morning weather update brought to you by WSKITV.com, Channel 17, and sponsored by the Widowmaker upstairs at the base lodge. Wednesday, today, we're looking at a partly sunny day. Temperatures at summit around 5 to 9 degrees with winds 30 to 45, gusting up to 60. So expect some wind hold today and first person to T3 wins. On Thursday, we're looking at a very, very, very cold day. Negative 8 to negative 4 at the summit with winds 25 to 40, gusting to 55. So definitely bundle up tomorrow, and it'll be a great morning to stay home and watch to win on Channel 17. On Friday, your extended forecast. We're looking partly sunny, 15 at the base, 7 at the top. On Saturday, mostly sunny, 28 at the base, 14 at the top. And Sunday, 31 at the base, 17 at the top. So your extended forecast, not too bad at all. It is going to be a little breezy, though. Your Birchwood Interior Trail Report for Wednesday. We're looking at 149 trails out there. 12 lifts getting you there. 50 of them were groomed up to near perfection. And in the last 24 hours, we had 7 inches of snow. So remember, cat skiing, make reservations, and Bracket Basin is open. But be careful. Central Mountain Grooming. We've got Timberline, Bridle Chain, Tote Road, Haywire, King's Landing, Spurline, Hayburner, White Nitro, Narrow Gauge, Comp Hill, Sluice, Lower Winter Way, Candyside, Boardwalk, Landings, Birches, and Snowbrook to get you up from the condos. On the east side, you've got Hallback, Ramdown, Boomauger. A little lower on the mountain, you've got Two Hall, Whiffletree, Cruiser, Slasher, Rollaway. On the west side, Scoot, Horseshoe, West Mountain, and Good Chance. And the Dropline Terrain Park was newly rebuilt, so check that out. At 8 o'clock, you got Snubber coming up from the condos. 8:30, you got Sawduster and Skidway. And 9 o'clock, Moosecalator. At 8:30, you've got Double Runner East. 9 o'clock, Double Runner West. That gets you a little higher on the mountain. And West Mountain, 8 o'clock, gets you up to go to the Super Quad. And 8:30, you got Super Quad and Skyline to get you higher up on the mountain. King Pine and Whiffletree, 8:30. King Pine's more advanced terrain. Whiffletree's a little easier terrain. And Timberline and 3T is 9 o'clock. Timberline most likely will probably be on hold. Your current outdoor cross-country skiing conditions is looking really good, but the ice rink is closed due to snow, but they are going to try to get that back open soon. And Fat Biking, Narrow Gauge, and on the Outdoor Center, please give the groomers and snowshoers a little bit of time to help get that trail back up and running. And if you're looking to volunteer, please stop by and help out with snowshoes. Vacation week, tonight, we've got Snowshoe Safari at the Outdoor Center and at the hotel, game night and movie night. You can find all that out at sugarloaf.com. And don't forget, Thursday, Watch to Win. Thursday, Friday, and Saturday is Watch and Win. 7:30 in the morning until 9 a.m. and 5:30 to 7. And don't forget, we have live shows every day, 7:30 to 9. And you can find all this out, plus much, much more, on WSKITV.com. Channel 17, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is where we hang out. We will see you on the mountain.
Welcome to the all-new Widowmaker. Featuring a newly renovated rooftop deck. All new menu and upgrade dining options. Home of the Sugarloaf Mosaic. 20 main brewed beers on tap. Visit Sugarloaf's premier nightlife and music venue today. Sugarloaf.com.
The following is a list of snow day closings due to inclement weather. All two-wheel drive crossovers should close for the day. Wannabe SUVs should close for the day. Regular four-door sedans should close for the foreseeable future. All cheap 4x4 vehicles will remain open, despite the harsh weather conditions.
Now purchase and get $2,000 bonus cash, or well-qualified lessees can lease the 2019 Jeep Wrangler for $281 a month.
We're back. There's our live quad cam shot. It is available on our website, WSKITV.com, and brought to you today by the Widowmaker, halfway to reggae, and then celebrating with some Baxter Brews on tap and cans, halfway to reggae. And we are looking at some sunshine today. We are looking at some potential wind issues today. We will bring you up to date. Captain Kip running a little behind. We've talked to him this morning. He will be down. He'll give us our first tracks report. And do want to let you know, Dropline is open with a brand new build. That is going to be some exciting stuff. And they have been working real hard on that. 149 trails open, trail and trail extensions. 50 of those are groomed out. And looking like a little... I think it's a westerly breeze up there, but we will find out when we talk to TOS. We'll find out more about that. And right now we're going to find more about some activities here for you and the family to enjoy here on the Mountain Report this morning. Want to let you know, of course, there is going to be a snowshoe safari at the Outdoor Center today, 10 until 12, and then 1 until 3. At the hotel, you'll see family game night, 4 to 6, family movie night tonight as well. Off the Wall will be out there as well, doing some juggling on Main Street at 3:30. Looney Moose Cafe has opened new ownership, and they are serving up breakfast and lunch, so you stop by there for some tasty breakfast and lunch. And if you're looking for a fast buffet lunch, well, the Shipyard's your place. Ski down to the Birches. Hop back on Sawduster, get back out there and enjoy it. If you love fresh bread, if you love tasty treats, well, Deli's has got it for you. Sandwiches, paninis, soups, and great desserts as well. Coffee, Java Joe's, that's the place right there on Main Street. Some of the world's best coffee, open daily 7 until 5 o'clock, Java Joe's. 45 North, open daily. They've got music on Saturdays, 3 to 5. Daily happy hour with specials and dinner nightly. 5 until 9, breakfast buffet going on right now. sport and fitness centers open, and you've got the hot tubs, swim pools, all those great activities, and they've got some classes too coming up, so you can go down there and check out some of their great activities and enjoy their amenities. Anti-Gravity Complex, they are open today, 6 a.m. till 9 p.m. And they have got, today is Pilates going on right now. Tomorrow is Pound at 8 o'clock, co-ed volleyball at 6 o'clock tomorrow as well. There will not be co-ed volleyball tomorrow. That's the new scoop. Look at that. Casey's Creativity Center has got their clay pottery studio going on this morning, 10 o'clock. Carabasset Valley Public Library, Owls of Maine. It's been rescheduled for today at 4:30. And you want to keep your reservation, let them know. And because the owls sell out fast, I'll tell you what, it's a who's who of fun right there. And 27 degrees, as I mentioned, and we are going to get a first track report from Captain Kip coming up. But I do want to remind you of this. Keith, we are excited, are we not? We are excited because we are giving away some Joe James custom artwork rugs, and we have two of them to give away. Now, here's how it's going to work. Watch and Win begins on Thursday morning. It goes Thursday, it goes Friday, Friday evening, Saturday, Saturday evening, Sunday morning. We'll give away two carpets, Joe James carpets. One will be some questions that Joe has come up with on Gandhi, so you want to do a little bit of research on Gandhi cars. The other one will be accumulation, easy to say, of all of our winners, and we'll draw for the other carpet. We've got two to give away. Going to be a big weekend. Also, you'll qualify for the amalgam skis, and we got a whole truckload of stuff. Anything that's not tied down in the studio, we're going to give it away. Why not? Even some of the things that are tied down. 7 inches of fresh powder out there, and it's a nice, light, fluffy powder. So make sure you get out and take advantage of that, all groomed up. We're looking pretty good today, and we will keep you posted as to what the lift status is here today. Captain Kip making his way down. They were a little late getting the TOS going here this morning, but fear not. We're trained for this. 7 inches of snow. We love it. Hey, let's take a break. We'll come back with more here on the Mountain Report. Don't go away.
Mountainside Real Estate is the leading real estate company at Sugarloaf and in Carabasset Valley. They sell 75% of the properties in the town of Carabasset Valley. That includes Reddington and the Lower Valley, as well as up on the mountain. In the last 12 months, they've had 167 transactions, and their closest competitor only had 22. Four full-time agents with combined experience of over 77 years selling real estate. Visit them today in their conveniently located Slopeside office. They know the Sugarloaf market like nobody else.
Yes, it's the first word of any new discovery. But when allergies attack, the excitement fades. Allegra helps you say yes with the fastest non-drowsy allergy relief and turn any half-hearted yes into an all-in yes. Allegra, live your life, not your allergies.
The Sugarloaf Sports and Fitness Center offers guests a variety of relaxation and fitness options with an indoor pool, hot tubs, weight room, racquetball courts, full-service spa and salon, and cafe. Offering a variety of food options like pizza, sandwiches, salads, and breakfast items, they'll even feed you as well. Grab a hot tub or a slice of pizza today, located on Mountainside Road, or ski there via the Birches Trail.
Deliver extra life or extra power?
Extra life.
Extra power.
Extra life.
Extra power.
Extra life.
Power.
Life.
Power.
Extra life.
No need to argue. Versus Coppertop, Duracell Optimum delivers extra life in some devices or extra power in others.
Jake here, and on behalf of my fellow canines, I'm asking why our owners are giving us topicals and chewables to kill and repel ticks. Don't you know that these are pesticides? At the very least, they make us feel not so good for a while. Why resort to these methods when you could just get us Dog Not Gone's tick-repelling dog vest? It's made with a permethrin-treated fabric, and even if it gets wet, it doesn't come off on our skin or yours. In our opinion, this is a much better alternative to keep ticks and other insects off us. For information, go online or visit the Skowhegan Factory Outlet.
We're back. There's our live quad cam shot brought to you by the Widowmaker. And way up on the hill somewhere, we have Captain Kip. And you are at the waiting to get on.
Hi, Greg. I'm right at the bottom of a skyline, and they're just a couple of adjustments they're trying to make to get it going. I know the T-bar is scheduled to open at 9, and it may be a little earlier, Greg, if they have an issue with Skyline or not. But it's starting to snow. I mean, it was sunny, and now it's starting to snow, so I think we're going to have snow squalls quite often. It's not as cold as you may think. I did wear some down just because when I get up at 6:15, it was howling. As I look up Skyline, and you guys can see, it's pretty breezy up there.
Right.
So we'll see what happens. It's not that cold though. It's relatively relatively warm. I've got my mittens and a down jacket on.
Yep.
It's going to be. I don't know that we're. I'm thinking right here we've got maybe 5 inches of new snow, but it's kind of hard to tell because of the breeze. It's blowing in so much. But I'd say in behind it, it's about 5 inches of new snow. It's gonna be a great day of skiing. As soon as I can get a run in, I will check in, Greg.
Well, thanks, Captain. And you're first in line, though, right?
Oh, yes. I'm right first in line. There was a couple of people here that I hip-checked out of the way, but I'm ready to go.
Perfect.
There you go. That a boy.
Right.
Thank you, Captain. We'll look forward to your next
report. And
sure.
We appreciate you calling in. Thank you.
Brought to you by Downhill Supply Company, and we have got some more things to talk about here this morning because there's a lot going on. It's vacation week, and let's bring you some more information, and we'll come back in a little bit to talk to a ski patrol. They're kind of busy today, but at this moment, so let's take a look at some more things happening here this morning on the Mountain Report.
The WSKI TV 17 Weather Report is brought to you by the Widowmaker. Find them upstairs in the base lodge.
Good morning, all you skiers, riders, and shredders out there. And this is your morning weather update brought to you by WSKITV.com, Channel 17, and sponsored by the Widowmaker upstairs of the base lodge. Wednesday, today, we're looking at a partly sunny day. Temperatures at summit around 5 to 9 degrees with winds 30 to 45, gusting up to 60. So expect some wind hold today, and first person to T3 wins. On Thursday, we're looking at a very, very, very cold day, negative 8 to negative 4 at the summit with winds 25 to 40, gusting to 55. So definitely bundle up tomorrow, and it'll be a great morning to stay home and watch to win on Channel 17. On Friday, your extended forecast. We're looking partly sunny, 15 at the base, 7 at the top. On Saturday, mostly sunny, 28 at the base, 14 at the top. And Sunday, 31 at the base, 17 at the top. So your extended forecast, not too bad at all. It is going to be a little breezy, though. Your Birchwood Interior Trail Report for Wednesday. We're looking at 149 trails out there. 12 lifts getting you there. 50 of them were groomed up to near perfection. And in the last 24 hours, we had 7 inches of snow. So remember, cat skiing, make reservations, and Bracket Basin is open. But be careful. Central Mountain Grooming, we've got Timberline, Bridle Chain, Tote Road, Haywire, King's Landing, Spurline, Hayburner, White Nitro, Narrow Gauge, Comp Hill, Sluice, Lower Winter Way, Candy Side, Boardwalk, Landings, Birches, and Snowbrook to get you up from the condos. On the east side, you've got Hallback, Ramdown, Boomauger. A little lower on the mountain, you've got Two Hall, Wiffle Tree, Cruiser, Slasher, Rollaway. On the west side, Scoot, Horseshoe, West Mountain, and Good Chance. And the Dropline Terrain Park was newly rebuilt, so check that out. At 8 o'clock, you got Snubber coming up from the condos. 8:30, you got Sawduster and Skidway. And 9 o'clock, Mooskalator. At 8:30, you've got Double Runner East. 9 o'clock, Double Runner West. That gets you a little higher on the mountain. And West Mountain, 8 o'clock, gets you up to go to the Super Quad. And 8:30, you got Super Quad and Skyline to get you higher up on the mountain. King Pine and Wiffle Tree, 8:30. King Pine's more advanced terrain. Wiffle Tree's a little easier terrain. And Timberline and 3T. is 9 o'clock. Timberline most likely will probably be on hold. Your current outdoor cross-country skiing conditions is looking really good, but the ice rink is closed due to snow, but they are going to try to get that back open soon. And fat biking, narrow gauge, and on the outdoor center, please give the groomers and snowshoers a little bit of time to help get that trail back up and running. And if you're looking to volunteer, please stop by and help out with snowshoes. Vacation week, tonight, we've got snowshoe safari at the outdoor center and at the hotel, game night and movie night. You can find all that out at sugarloaf.com. And don't forget, Thursday, watch to win. Thursday, Friday, and Saturday is watch and win. 7:30 in the morning until 9 a.m. and 5:30 to 7. And don't forget, we have live shows every day, 7:30 to 9. And you can find all this out, plus much, much more, on WSKITV.com. Channel 17, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is where we hang out. We will see you on the mountain.
Hello, I'm Earl Morris, owner of Birchwood Interiors. For 31 years, we've been providing you, our fellow Sugarloafers, with furniture, flooring, mattresses, and window treatments. But what many Sugarloafers don't realize is the amount of construction and new renovation work that we do. From fireplaces to kitchens to bathrooms and steam showers, we do anything inside the walls of a house. We love what we do and hope you'll shop locally with us.
Gatorade Zero. All the electrolytes, zero sugar.
Level 3, huh? That's a start.
All day, baby.
NBA champion?
Boom, and I really care with my bumping tool. Bulldozer, make room. Write that pun for the tune. Wish they all had my leg room. Another deal, it ain't even noon. Tour Dior, or sit by the pool. I can do...
Hey!
Nah, we not like that.
Gatorade Zero. Get more out of zero.
We're back. There is a big cloud hugging, and there's some flurry action in there as well. Temperatures have dropped to 21, 6 degrees in the last. It's that big old cloud right there. We're looking at some wind. Kip is going to bring us a report. We'll keep you posted on that. Want to let you know, narrow gauge trail and has no fat biking today because of the snow, obviously. And the crew will be grooming out the single track, so they're looking for some volunteers to snowshoe, help pack it down. And the flight of Tim Flight, he'll be heading on through with the groomer. So they're looking for some volunteers for that. Want to let you know that. And also, the skating rink, obviously, is closed until they can get that cleared off. So that is the most current status down there. Drop line opens today after a big rebuild. And they're pretty excited about that. We will talk to someone here at the top of the mountain here in just a bit, but they're a little tied up at the moment, so we're not going to bother them. But we are going to suggest that you get that cup of coffee, and we're going to give you a little information on where to get that. But first, let's give you some more information about what's going on here on the Mountain Report. And of course, the Ski Museum of Maine, a great place to visit right there in downtown Sugarloaf, right up above the outlet store. Private tours are available, and you can stop by and get your bait right there, live bait for ice fishing and many other locally handmade bowls, fishing, hunting, and hiking gear at Salampas Trading Post right there in Kingfield. Off the beaten path, you can stop by there and enjoy great music tonight, 5:30 with Dan Merrill, and they've got a rock and roll party coming up. And so you'll want to make sure that you get out there and check it out. Globe Bowling happens Friday, music on Saturdays, and of course, many great things to eat at the Sugar Bowl, and the shuttle will drop you off there, pick you up. New and improved, the Widowmaker, open at 11 o'clock. The Steve's Duo today, 3 until 6 o'clock. Chase's Chairlift Trivia today. Open mic night. Chairlift Trivia is on Monday. Open mic night tonight, and music on the weekend, of course, at the Rack. At the Stratton Plaza, you can enjoy Friday karaoke. Sing your little heart out. Saturday night, live auction, Arnold Trail Snowmobile Club fundraiser. Great food, great fun. And a live auction, your opportunity to win $10,000. It's at gocva.com/raffle. Of course, we'll have them on the show to talk about that. Maybe reveal a winner. Who knows? turning guests into locals since 1979. Check out our website, WSKITV.com, where we are streaming live. We also have a time-lapse camera as well. And Watch and Win takes place. It will begin the 20th all the way through the 23rd. We've got great prizes, a couple of Joe James custom-made artwork rugs, and more. You'll have a chance to win those Amalgam skis at the end of the season as well, handmade in Freeport, Maine. And lots of other things that we're giving away. We got a big Watch and Win. Hope you all tune in for that. And of course, we'll have a lot of fun with that. 21 degrees, as I mentioned, and as I mentioned, a great place to get a cup of coffee. Let's take a peek. We give you a little tip and a place to get coffee right here in this little segment. Did you know if you walk in backwards that your glasses won't actually fog up?
That's true.
It is true, isn't it?
It is true, yes.
People think I'm making it up. It's not.
No, it's not. It's true. If you walk backwards, you get circulation in it.
Well, there you go. We're getting it right here. And look at this. Did you just win a big hand?
No, but I'm just counting money. But
you always win when you're at Java Joe's.
Yeah, exactly. Definitely. How's it going?
It's going great. I know you have a lot of specialty coffees. Out of all the specialty coffees that you sell, what's the most popular?
Bad Dog is like the huge favorite
right,
here. Yeah, definitely. I don't know. Right now, the Tanzania is really, I like it. It's really, really good. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's like, I don't know. I'm not fancy enough to know. But that one's really good. People like that one.
Yeah.
Backdraft, it's smoky. People like that for the dark flavor kind of thing. But I don't know.
You know what I'm enjoying is the new blend. And you have some, Sparky's blend.
Yes. Oh, my God. It's actually great. It's like half the espresso bean, which is Skyline, and then half Backdraft, the really, really dark one. Anyways, it's so good.
And it's never bitter. It's always very, it's good.
It's like smooth. I don't know. I'm not like a coffee aficionado. But it's really cool. And it's awesome because Caitlin, who is Rob's daughter, she did the artwork on it, which is really fun.
A fine tribute to fly fishing.
Totally, definitely. And it's her dad, you know, it's for her dad's coffee. And every quarter, $3 goes towards whatever, you know, care about.
King's Kids.
Yes, King's Kids right now. And then they're different, you know, as it goes kind of thing. So, but that's super cool. And it's really fun because everybody's like, it's cool when you get like, people love the coffee and it's good coffee. And then they're also kind of helping with something. So that's kind of like a cool little bonus.
It's no torture, I'll tell you that.
Yeah, exactly. Like, if I have to drink good coffee, I guess I can do it kind of thing. But, yeah, that's the one right now. That's really, really good.
Thank you for your coffee commentary. I love coffee. I appreciate your passion.
Yeah, no, it's so good. I actually only started drinking it, like, right before I got this job, and I was like, I understand people now. I'm like, oh, this is why, like, people get up now. Like, I got it kind of thing. And yeah, no, it's, I feel very lucky that I got to start out with coffee, like, here.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like,
and now you can get up before 12.
Exactly. And I get up and I'm like, nice to people. It's kind of a game changer. It's really good.
Thank you very much for your time. We appreciate it. Here at Java Joe, stop by. And what's your name?
I'm Izzy. Yeah.
Stop by and see Izzy right here.
Yeah.
We're back. Our live quad cam shot with some flurries coming down. You know, we like that. As I always like to say, we're trained for that. Super Quad is running, and we'll check with Ski Patrol soon. And also, Captain Kip will join us here with his first tracks report. The new 2020 plan has been unleashed. We're going to talk with Carl Strand on Saturday and talk more about some great things happening here at Sugarloaf. And of course, in the long-awaited downhill mountain biking, it's going to finally take place. And we are looking forward to some great upgrades here at Sugarloaf. It was some very good news. And we're going to talk at depth about that with Carl Strand on the program on Saturday and find out more about these great plans. I want to remind you, tomorrow night, the Mallet Brothers will take the stage at the Widowmaker, and that is going to be a great show. You'll want to definitely be involved in that. 149 trails and trail extensions, 50 of those groomed out. No fat biking today till they get the trail groomed out, but they are looking for some volunteers to maybe do a little stomping on the trail on that single track, and then they can groom it out. And once again, drop line open today. And Skyline is now spinning, so that's good news. We'll see Captain Kip right after this break. So we'll take a break, we'll come back, and hopefully we'll have a first tracks report and more here on the Mountain Report. Stay with us.
Well, welcome to the Ski Museum of Maine here in beautiful downtown Kingfields, right here on the corner of Main Street. We're open Wednesdays through Sundays from noon to 4. We're covering all aspects of skiing in Maine. Maine has a lot of highlights in the world of skiing, but we're also trying to capture that local feel. You don't know where you're going if you don't know where you've come from. And this is where we came from. This is how we got to where we are skiing today.
Doritos Cool Ranch just got cooler.
West Mountain Ski Company, providing completely custom ski shapes and designs, as well as a selection of standard skis with customizable graphics. Check them out online at westmountainskis.com or visit the West Mountain Factory on Mountain at Sugarloaf today. Check out WSKITV.com on all your mobile devices. Local mountain and lakes forecast, dozens of videos of things to do, everyone a reason to stay another day. Know before you go with WSKI TV 17 and WSKITV.com.
We talk about tax smart investing. What's new?
Well, Audrey's expecting.
Twins.
Grandparents.
We want to put money aside for them, so changing plans.
All right, let's see what we can adjust.
We'd be closer to the twins.
Changing plans.
Okay.
Mom, are you painting again? You could sell these.
Let me guess. Changing plans?
At Fidelity, a change in plans is always part of the plan.
We're back, and we just talked to TOS. They just walked through the shack, or I'm sorry, the hut. We don't have shacks here. They just got in, so we're going to have to wait to find out with them. Of course, Skyline is turning now. We'll let you know more information as we can gather it. We're going to check back with them. But right now, we're going to take a look at a piece that we just shot that we're pretty excited about, the Anti-Gravity Complex. Now, wait a minute. The full name is the Carabasset Valley Anti-Gravity Recreational Complex. Well, it's a long one, but let's take a look at the AGC. We are here at the Carabasset Valley Anti-Gravity Recreational Complex. We just call it the AGC. And there's a whole lot of fun in here. We're going to take you inside and show you. We are here at the Anti-Gravity Complex, and we're going to take a look at some of the fun things to do here. I got my helmet. I need to attach it. But right now, we'll first look at the climbing wall. This is the Clumbeagan climbing wall, of course. This looks pretty cool. This is just some of the indoor fun that the Anti-Gravity Complex has. Come on, we'll show you more. Hey, if it has anything to do with the ball, probably gonna happen right here. Maybe you wanna shoot some hoops, volleyball, pickleball, or maybe just take some laps right around the gym. Sure is comfortable, and they got tunes. We are here at the trampolines. This looks totally awesome right down here. It does require reservations, and it's booked up quite often, but I'll tell you what, I can see why. This looks like fun. How big is the bowl? Look, it's big. Put your helmet on and come on in. It's best with a skateboard or maybe some inline skates. Hey, here at the AGC, whether you're looking to maybe burn some calories off or maybe you're looking to tone up your look, either way, you can do it right here. All the exercise equipment anyone would ever need, and it's handicap accessible right here. There's an elevator. You're at the AGC. Got it going on. We are here in the workout. This is where yoga classes and weights and all kinds of fun things. Spin class takes place here. And your choice of balls over here in the corner. Check it out. Hey, little kitchen area right here. Perhaps a little kids party here. Great idea. Look, in that machine, no soda, just water. So next time you're on the hill, maybe it's a windhold day, or you just want to come unwind with some friends after the slopes close. Right here, the anti-gravity complex. Bottom of the access road, take a right and another hard right, right past the library. It's big. Come and join them. We're back. Look, sun is shining brightly. Super Quad is running, and we've got a little bit of flurries and some sunshine over there. And we're looking good. A little bit of a lift line. Not much at all for a vacation week. And lots of things going on, of course, vacation week. Once again, at the hotel, Arts and Crafts happening 12 to 2. And that'll be some fun, of course. Horse and carriage rides were yesterday, but they've got yoga happening at 9:30 at the Sport and Fitness Center and Snowshoe Safari at the Outdoor Center. That'll be a 10 o'clock and 1 o'clock, two tours. And Long John Yoga, 2 p.m. at the Caribou Room of the hotel. So get yourself some Long Johns and show up. That'll be fun, huh? Discover CVA happens at 3 o'clock. Your opportunity to ask some questions and view the facility. That is called Discover CVA at CVA, 3 o'clock. Off the Wall Juggling on Main Street at 3:30. Now, if you've never seen anyone crawl through a tennis racket, that is the place you'll want to be. Family Game Night at the hotel, 4 to 6. Family Movie Night at the hotel at 6 o'clock. And the Steve Jones Duo at 3 until 6 o'clock at the Widowmaker. And Captain Kip has made his way down, and he's got some information for us. And he has been on that fresh snow. And how's it feel, Cap?
Oh, boy, it's nice to have a little powder today.
It's an honest five inches
on the snow.
A little hard to tell up top because the wind was blowing so hard that it scoured at the top of Skyline. The lift is going to be comfortable riding up, but that whole area has been blown off quite a bit. I came down because I was sort of in a hurry to get here. I came to the right, went down Double Bitter over to Hayburner, and about four turns into Hayburner, it's powdered from side to side. So it was really, really good skiing, although windy, and I'm glad I wore the down, even though the temperature says, it's in the 20s, but with this breeze, I'm glad I'm warmed up. It's good skiing, and if you ever want to try out any wider skis, Greg, today's go over to the Downhill Supply Company and demo some wider skis. I'm on the Volcom Matras today, 96 underfoot. Great ski for this. It's long enough and wide enough for me to stay on top of the snow. It's fluffy. There's not a lot of moisture to it or density, even though it's windblown. It's really great skiing. People are really, really going to enjoy this.
Nice, light, fluffy powder, and more flurries going on. Love it.
Yes, it's not going to stop. It's like almost like a ski resort. It's snowing.
Crazy, huh?
I know.
So we tried to talk to someone at top of Skyline. They just walked through the door, so we don't have much information yet.
Yeah, well, they had a small issue. Took us a little bit. They had to get a part, so they drove down to Jordan's. No, I'm just kidding. They had to come down here to maintenance and get a little fuse, and then it was running fine. Everything's fine. But so all the lifts going, the T-bar's ready to go in case anything gets on wind hold. You can ride the T-bar outside of the wind. It'll be great skiing.
fantastic. It is a lot of great powder out there to be had, so hopefully we'll have a chance. And the temperatures are getting a little bit colder here, Captain.
Well, it's supposed to get colder as the day goes on, Greg, and the wind picks up. So I think between now and noon, it's going to be the best skiing and the best availability to get to the top. Although I found the snow better from Super Quad down. I'm going to take another run and try and get to the east side, see what's going on over there. And you know what else? They all got all the new Yeti stuff at the Downhill Supply Company, all the cups and mugs and all that stuff. So go in and see the folks there and get some great stuff and try and demo some skis.
Fantastic. Great, Kip. And we'll look forward to your information wherever you may flow out there.
Right. If I'm a little slow, it's because I'm just eating up the powder.
Okay, fair enough. All right, thanks. Kip Files brought to you by the Downhill Supply Company. Gosh, I was at the Downhill Supply Company yesterday, and they were a busy place. There were a lot of people there taking advantage of some great deals. 21 degrees, as Kip just mentioned. We'll come back. We'll hopefully speak to a ski patrol and give you some more information coming up in just a little bit. But we'll take a break now, and we'll be right back.
The WSKI TV 17 Weather Report is brought to you by the Widowmaker. Find them upstairs in the base lodge.
Good morning, all you skiers, riders, and shredders out there. And this is your morning weather update brought to you by WSKITV.com, Channel 17, and sponsored by the Widowmaker upstairs at the base lodge. Wednesday, today, we're looking at a partly sunny day. Temperatures at summit around 5 to 9 degrees with winds 30 to 45, gusting up to 60. So expect some wind hold today, and first person to T3 wins. On Thursday, we're looking at a very, very, very cold day, negative 8 to negative 4 at the summit with winds 25 to 40, gusting to 55. So definitely bundle up tomorrow, and it'll be a great morning to stay home and watch to win on Channel 17. On Friday, your extended forecast. We're looking partly sunny, 15 at the base, 7 at the top. On Saturday, mostly sunny, 28 at the base, 14 at the top. And Sunday, 31 at the base, 17 at the top. So your extended forecast, not too bad at all. It is going to be a little breezy, though. Your Birchwood Interior Trail Report for Wednesday. We're looking at 149 trails out there. 12 lifts getting you there. 50 of them were groomed up to near perfection. And in the last 24 hours, we had 7 inches of snow. So remember, cat skiing, make reservations, and Bracket Basin is open. But be careful. Central Mountain Grooming, we've got Timberline, Bridle Chain, Tote Road, Haywire, King's Landing, Spurline, Hayburner, White Nitro, Narrow Gauge, Comp Hill, Sluice, Lower Winter Way, Candy Side, Boardwalk, Landings, Birches, and Snowbrook to get you up from the condos. On the east side, you've got Hallback, Ramdown, Boomauger. A little lower on the mountain, you've got Two Hall, Whiffletree, Cruiser, Slasher, Rollaway. On the west side, Scoot, Horseshoe, West Mountain, and Good Chance. And the Dropline Terrain Park was newly rebuilt, so check that out. At 8 o'clock, you got Snubber coming up from the condos. 8:30, you got Sawduster and Skidway. And 9 o'clock, Mooskalator. At 8:30, you've got Double Runner East. 9 o'clock, Double Runner West. That gets you a little higher on the mountain. And West Mountain, 8 o'clock, gets you up to go to the Super Quad. And 8:30, you got Super Quad and Skyline to get you higher up on the mountain. King Pine and Whiffletree, 8:30. King Pine's more advanced terrain. Whiffletree's a little easier terrain. And Timberline and 3T is 9 o'clock. Timberline most likely will probably be on hold. Your current outdoor cross-country skiing conditions is looking really good, but the ice rink is closed due to snow, but they are going to try to get that back open soon. And Fat Biking, Narrow Gauge, and on the Outdoor Center, please give the groomers and snowshoers a little bit of time to help get that trail back up and running. And if you're looking to volunteer, please stop by and help out with snowshoes. Vacation week, tonight, we've got snowshoe safari at the Outdoor Center and at the hotel, game night and movie night. You can find all that out at sugarloaf.com. And don't forget, Thursday, watch to win. Thursday, Friday, and Saturday is Watch and Win, 7:30 in the morning until 9 a.m. and 5:30 to 7. And don't forget, we have live shows every day, 7:30 to 9. And you can find all this out, plus much, much more, on WSKITV.com. Channel 17, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is where we hang out. We will see you on the mountain.
Welcome to the all-new Widowmaker. Featuring a newly renovated rooftop deck. All-new menu and upgrade dining options. Home of the Sugarloaf Mosaic. 20 main brewed beers on tap. Visit Sugarloaf's premier nightlife and music venue today. Sugarloaf.com.
Only one life to live, you're never gonna get it back. Let's go.
Get 60% off your second guest and start wandering now. Come seek the Royal Caribbean.
We're back, live quad cam shot brought to you by the Widowmaker. You know they have a breakfast buffet at the 45 North Hotel going on right now until 10 o'clock. Cat coming off the hill, 21 degrees.
Next one's short
ads. And we, they have got Skyline running, and we're going to talk to Roddy here in a moment, but we weren't able to get a hold of him quite yet. But we are going to get a report from Roddy coming up in just a moment. Another report from Captain Kip coming up as well. There it is, right up there at the top, and looking like some good snow flurries happening. Temperatures are supposed to dip today, so keep that in mind. You know, there's a great film at the Alphont Competition Center tonight at 6 o'clock, the Teton Gravity Research film. And, you know, they got a nice big screen there and a nice sound system as well. That'll be a great movie. There is a small fee for that, but go check that out. It happens at 6 o'clock at the Competition Center, and that is tonight, and you should go visit. We'll take a break. When we come back, we are going to talk to Roddy and find out more about what's going on. And another report from Captain Kip. We'll be right back.
Good morning!
We talk about tax smart investing. What's new?
Well, Audrey's expecting.
Twins.
Grandparents.
We want to put money aside for them, so change in plans.
All right, let's see what we can adjust.
We'd be closer to the twins.
Change in plans.
Okay.
Mom, are you painting again? You could sell these.
Let me guess. Change in plans?
At Fidelity, a change in plans is always part of the plan.
Dust and bark, vroom, chainsaw, stacking wood, oh, so good. Thump, thump, thump.
That is not your average logger.
They get eaten by a bear, but it doesn't matter because I have a lot of...
Favorite thing at the bag?
The burger.
I think the French onion soup.
The bag burger.
Great pizza, great burger.
The Valentine. The beer.
A bag burger and a pepperoni pizza.
Love the bag burgers and the curly fries.
Soup and Valentine.
The Gucci burger.
Looking at all the happy faces.
I enjoy the intellectual banter.
The burgers. That's easy.
Atmosphere and the company.
Delicious.
When I started this commute, everyone said I was crazy. So 15 years ago, I got my first Subaru, and I did it anyway. For more than 500,000 miles, my Outback always got me there. So when it was time, of course I got a new one. Because my kids still need me, and I need them.
Welcome to
the all-new Subaru Outback, the most reliable Outback ever. Go where love takes you.
There it is. The lines are forming and the lifts are turning, and Roddy is on the phone. Roddy, good morning to you, sir.
Good morning to you. How are you, Greg?
I am living the dream as always, and it's looking a little breezy here, and there's some flurries coming down. What's it like out there?
Yeah. Well, it's kind of deceptive. There's, you know, in Sugarloaf terms, quote unquote, hardly a breath of wind until you get to the unload of Skyline, and then it ramps right up to a solid, like, 45 to 60. So we have the Skyline going. It's good for now.
Yep.
Looks like King Pine and Timberline will begin the day on wind hold. And the wind forecast is really not showing that the winds are going to go anywhere, neither down or up. So as of right now, it's not really affecting too much of the lift operation. So hopefully we'll just stick with what we got and have a good day.
There you go. Any racing or any activities we should know about?
There's some CVA training going on, but they are not closing any trails because we're sensitive to having a pretty busy week.
Right.
So just be mindful in the usual spots, lower comp and lower gauge. You'll see some slalom or GS courses off to the side. They'll be bannered. Try to stay out of their way and enjoy the other three quarters of the trail that we left open for you.
How much snow do you think we got?
It's really hard to say up here because it's been blowing around all night. I would guess probably 8 to 10 would be a fair estimate. But like I said, it's blowing around so much, it's really hard to tell.
Spread it around a little bit. We don't mind.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's what we say. You know, you get a foot of wind and then a foot of snow and then 3 feet of wind, you know?
It does happen. Seems
yeah.
like that way, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Bracket Basin open today?
Bracket Basin is open. Burnt Mountain is open. Catskiing is running. Kind of a last-minute decision there, but they opened the sale for that up yesterday late morning, and it sounds like it booked right up. So everybody's
right.
Chomping at the bit.
Well, make some reservations for yourself if you're looking to do that now or in the future. Looking like today and tomorrow they'll be cat skiing, right?
Yeah, tomorrow as well, and
yep.
Then we'll pick it back up for the weekend.
Cool.
Yep.
Hey, what's your choice of the day, Roddy?
Geez, with fresh snow, just about anything is fair game, you know?
Right.
I guess if for those not in the know, we'll just say the left-hand side of every trail.
Thanks, Roddy. We appreciate your time. Thanks for what you do up there.
Hey, thank you. Have a great day.
All right, Roddy. Thanks. Oops, I hung up on him. Maybe he'll call back. Well, joining us here this morning to talk about the Sunday teleclass that happens, it happens on Sunday, is Lisa and Liz. Welcome to the both of you.
Greg.
Now, you are a student and you are an instructor, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, how did you get involved, or when did you get involved?
Well, I saw Liz's piece on SKI with you, and I'd been tallying for a number of years, and I thought, this sounds great. It sounds like fun.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, we're glad you're watching. We're glad you're taking advantage of it,
so
too.
So am I.
So you are one of how many?
Four.
Yeah. So it sounds like you got room for more.
We have room for more. We actually, so the first... kind of the trial period was a 6 week Sunday mornings for 6 weeks, and this coming Sunday is the sixth week. Mm-hmm. So I've gotten permission to extend it for 3 weeks. So starting March 1st, 8th and 15th, we can have more people sign up for a 3 week kind of see what it's like, see if you want to do it. If you weren't able to do it the first time, but you wanted to because of commitments or what have you. You can jump in
chance.
On it. Second chance. So it's 3 weekends, 9 to 11, for $125.
Wow. So, Lisa, you said you've been
telemarketer.
No, we're not selling anything except for skiing.
for quite a few years.
Right.
So it doesn't sound like you joined to necessarily, did you join to learn better technique or just to?
Totally. Like for a tele tune-up.
Yeah.
Is basically, you know, why I joined the group.
Yeah.
And it's been so much fun. Liz challenges us all the time, just when you kind of think, like, okay, you got it. She challenges us, but then She also gives us tips and techniques, which makes it easier. Mm-hmm. So we can go harder, longer, steeper stuff, bumps. It's really been a lot of fun.
So did you start off as a teleskier or did you start off as a regular skier?
I start off as alpine. And I still do both. And getting better at tele has definitely helped me. I mean, my balance is just, I've kind of dialed that in mm-hmm. On my alpine, so. But.
Well, I've never freed the heel, on purpose anyway. so I'm kind of wondering, what are the best conditions for tele skiing? What do you really like to see? Firm, powder, what do you like to see? Or in all of the above?
Well, I mean, today's going to be great.
Yeah.
You know, the soft, like, packed powder, you know, that we're going to have tomorrow. will be perfect. Powder's great. It's the same as alpine. I mean, nobody likes the sheet of ice in front of you yeah. on any equipment, really, unless you're a racer.
Right. So you have room for some more people.
Yeah.
And you're going to sign up some more people. And you are an enthusiastic endorser of this program.
I'm signing up again for another 3 years.
She's extending.
She's extending.
She's already, yeah. I heard you already yeah. extended,
yeah.
actually.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Already signed
yeah.
up.
Yeah.
So.
Well, stay great. With us. We're going to come right back. We're going to talk more about the Perfect Turn Telecamp, our tele Sunday morning classes, and how you can get involved, and we'll talk more, and we'll be right back in just a moment.
The WSKI TV17 weather report is brought to you by the Widowmaker. Find them upstairs in the base lodge.
Good morning, all you skiers, riders, and shredders out there, and this is your morning weather update brought to you by WSKITV.com, Channel 17, and sponsored by the Widowmaker upstairs at the Base Lodge. Wednesday, today, we're looking at a partly sunny day. Temperatures at summit around 5 to 9 degrees with winds 30 to 45 gusting up to 60, so expect some wind hold today, and first person to T3 wins. On Thursday, we're looking at a very, very, very cold day, -8 to -4 at the summit with winds 25 to 40, gusting to 55, so definitely bundle up tomorrow, and it'll be a great morning to stay home and watch to win on Channel 17. On Friday, your extended forecast. We're looking partly sunny, 15 at the base, 7 at the top. On Saturday, mostly sunny, 28 at the base, 14 at the top. And Sunday, 31 at the base, 17 at the top. So your extended forecast, not too bad at all. It is going to be a little breezy, though. Your Birchwood Interior Trail Report for Wednesday. We're looking at 149 trails out there. 12 lifts getting you there, 50 of them were groomed up to near perfection, and in the last 24 hours, we had 7 inches of snow, so remember, cat skiing, make reservations, and Bracket Basin is open, but be careful. Central Mountain Grooming, we've got Timberline, Bridle Chain, Tote Road, Haywire, King's Landing, Spurline, Hayburner, White Nitro, Narrow Gauge, Comp Hill, Sluice, Lower Winter Way, Candy Side, Boardwalk, Landings, Birches, and Snowbrook to get you up from the condos. On the east side, you've got Hallback, Ramdown, Boomauger. A little lower on the mountain, you've got Two-Hall, Whiffletree, Cruiser, Slasher, Rollaway. On the west side, Scoot, Horseshoe, West Mountain, and Good Chance. And the Dropline Terrain Park was newly rebuilt, so check that out. At 8 o'clock, you got Snubber coming up from the condos. 8:30, you got Sawduster and Skidway. And 9 o'clock, Mooskalator. At 8:30, you've got Double Runner East. 9 o'clock, Double Runner West. That gets you a little higher on the mountain. And West Mountain, 8 o'clock, gets you up to go to the Super Quad. And 8:30, you got Super Quad and Skyline to get you higher up on the mountain. King Pine and Whiffletree, 8:30. King Pine's more advanced terrain. Whiffletree's a little easier terrain. And Timberline and 3T. Is 9 o'clock. Timberline most likely will probably be on hold. Your current outdoor cross-country skiing conditions is looking really good, but the ice rink is closed due to snow, but they are going to try to get that back open soon. And Fat Biking, Narrow Gauge, and on the Outdoor Center, please give the groomers and snowshoers a little bit of time to help get that trail back up and running. And if you're looking to volunteer, please stop by and help out with snowshoes. Vacation week tonight, we've got snowshoe safari at the Outdoor Center and at the hotel, game night and movie night. You can find all that out at sugarloaf.com. And don't forget, Thursday, watch to win. Thursday, Friday, and Saturday is watch and win, 7:30 in the morning until 9 a.m. and 5:30 to 7. And don't forget, we have live shows every day, 7:30 to 9. And you can find all this out, plus much, much more, on WSKITV.com. Channel 17, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is where we hang out. We will see you on the mountain.
I'm Michelle DeFrosia. I've been the business manager here at Birchwood Interiors for over a decade. I'm part of a team that I'm very proud of. Our company's goal to treat every customer who walks through the door as our best friend isn't just a slogan. Our clients really do become our friends. The trust that our clients put in us is refreshing in today's world. All of us at Birchwood Interiors seek every day to work with integrity and professionalism that will continue to earn that trust. We're in Village West, so come on in, pull up a sofa, and see what we can do for you.
Hello. I saw you move in, and I wanted to welcome you to the neighborhood with some homemade biscuits.
Oh, that's so nice.
And a little tip. GEICO could help you save on homeowners insurance.
Oh.
Cookies.
Biscuits.
Hmm. Is there a little nutmeg in there?
Oh, it's my mum's secret recipe.
You can tell me.
It's a secret.
Is it cinnamon?
It's my mum's secret recipe.
Call GEICO and see how easy saving on homeowners and condo insurance can be.
I'll come back for the plate.
So we are back, and Captain Kip is joining us at the top of the hill, and we're trying to get him on the Skyline camera here. He did just get off the lift. Tell us what's going
on. It's going to be a little tough for me to walk over there. It's kind of buffed out right now, Greg, with my ski boots.
Yeah, we won't make you do that. But
But I'm in the lee of the shack here at the top of Skyline. It's just squally. I see blue overhead, and then it snows. I'd say we got an honest 25, steady, gusted a little bit more than that. Yeah. Again, the best snow I have found is super quad down. I went down Spillway. It was absolutely outstanding, 4 or 5 inches. They groomed it and had about 4 or 5 inches of snow on it. There are a couple of spots where, because they're a little bit more exposed, you come out of the powder into some pretty firm snow. So just be careful if you're doing that. Dreadfort, you get rewarded for coming up here. It's only about, I'm looking at the thermometer. But best my eyes can see, it's around 18 degrees here, 17, 18 degrees, and pretty steady breeze. And it's not going to decrease at all. I think we're in the heat of the day. I think it's going to get colder and windier as the day gets on. So come on out. Run right over. It's 8:30. Run right over to Downhill Supply Company, Greg, and get some pow-pow skis. I'm going to head off toward the east. Maybe do White Nitro or Gandhi Line. You know, this is a payback I get for all those rainy days.
Exactly. You deserve it.
Right. Nobody wants to go first tracks with me when it's pouring rain, but boy, there were a whole bunch this morning.
Thank you, Kip. Great report. We appreciate your hard work out there today, and we'll look forward to another report.
I'll come in. I'll check in again.
Okay. No, all right. Thank you, Captain
Don't
Kip. Oh, right. Thank you. Appreciate that. We're so high tech here. Captain Kip, bringing you the First Tracks report brought to you by Downhill Supply Company. He says go over there and get some demos. One thing you probably aren't going to find is rigs over there to rent if you are going to get involved in your Sunday morning tele class. Where can they find some?
They can go to Happy Tunes.
Happy Tunes.
Happy Tunes. Yeah. See Lee and Elle. You can get new equipment. You can get used equipment. I know there's a couple of setups for sale.
Yeah.
Actually, there's two setups for sale that have skins with them.
Oh, that'd be nice.
I was just down there checking stuff out the other day, which is pretty cool. Mm-hmm. And I know he's got some demo stuff. That would be the place to go.
Do you guys do any skinning up or mostly just...
No, mostly just lifts. We only have 2 hours.
Oh, okay.
So it's short enough as it is.
So currently, people can sign up. What's the limit? How many people?
I don't know. I'd say, 8, 9 would be a good, healthy size class.
Whole parade of hooting
Yeah,
free healing
big.
People.
That would be great. Have a huge group going down.
Yeah,
we ski around and people are like, "What's this? A teleclass? We didn't know that that existed." So, you know, it's nice to be visible. Like, hey, right. It does exist.
Yeah. How do they get involved?
You can come take.
Can I just add one thing?
Oh, yeah.
Just that Liz, even though we're in a group, she individualizes for each of us, mm-hmm. and she's really really great on that. It's been so helpful.
She yells at everyone.
I do.
She does.
Yeah.
She,
no discrimination.
Yes, exactly. Like equal opportunity. And come join us, because it's like cross training. You know, if you're an alpine or a snowboarder and you're started tallying, it's.
Yeah, it's like it's a good, we've got a good like intermediate, mm-hmm. Upper intermediate skills working on, like we ski all the groomers, working into some bumps, working in, you know, conditions permitting, working into some trees.
Yeah.
Working in the exploring, but yeah, definitely.
I guess it's like anything else. The better you get, the more fun it is. Right?
Yeah, so they can call the Sugarloaf Perfect Turn or Skier Services office, mm-hmm. And ask for Liz's telegroup.
Perfect.
And yeah, the extension March 1, 8, and 15, Sundays from 9 to 11.
You've been saving all those Boeing rewards points?
Absolutely.
Spend them.
It's a pretty good deal.
Thank you, Liz. Thank you, Lisa. I'm glad.
Thanks, Greg.
I appreciate your enthusiasm, and thanks for sharing that you saw it here on mm-hmm. WSKI.
Yeah.
We appreciate you both coming on this morning. We'll take a break. You guys get out and enjoy. We'll be right back.
Excellent. Don't forget to.
Okay, for $10,000, how about teddy bears?
Don't flush.
That is right. Toilet paper.
Flush.
Baby wipes.
Don't flush. They go here.
Really?
That's right, Barry. Baby wipes are not designed to be flushed. They can clog pipes, either in your home or our sewer system, which can cost us all big bucks.
Wigs?
Flush? Save your pipes. Don't flush baby wipes.
This is The Life.
This is Our Life.
Make it your life.
Visit Mountainside Real Estate in the village at the base of the mountain.
Sugarloaf's exclusive real estate agency.
Tacos. Hey, you guys look like foodies. Would you like to try our trashy back ribs?
Oh, that sounds great.
Everything is locally harvested, farm to dumpster to table.
What else you got?
We have a melon rind stew. Comes with a pork and bean reduction.
Yeah, we're gonna just do a lap and we'll come back.
Okay, well, we'll be here. Man, why isn't this working?
My mouth is watering.
I think that's just your rabies flaring up.
With Geico, the savings keep on going. Just like this sequel. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
We got Crystal Pot Pies.
Check out WSKITV.com on all your mobile devices. Local mountain and lakes forecast, dozens of videos of things to do, everyone a reason to stay another day. Know before you go with WSKI TV 17 and WSKITV.com.
Home of the yard sale and many other delicious things. Is that true?
That's true.
Yeah. Is that one of the more popular ones?
It's getting pretty popular. Mm-hmm. It's becoming more of a, you know, well-known breakfast. So.
Well, you have great breakfast here. I've sampled it myself. It's delicious. Now, we've got a busy weekend coming up. What are you featuring? What are you tantalizing people's taste buds with?
So, I have some cheeseburger soup that's, like, requested a lot.
Oh.
So, I thought I'd whip that up for vacation weekend. Uh-huh. Also have some chorizo corn chowder, which has become the new fan favorite.
Oh, the chorizo sausage.
Yes, ooh, which is delicious. Ooh. And then we have some other little soups and...
Mm-hmm. What do you got with frosting on it?
Everything here. Our mud cake and our carrot cake, well known. Mm-hmm. Mud cake is always go-to for all ages.
That's like, that cookie's like two cookies.
Yes, our molasses and our chocolate chip cookies are huge. Mm-hmm.
Tell us when you're open.
We are open from 8 to 3 every day of the week, except for Saturdays when we're open until 4.
Hey, stop by Deli's. Why wouldn't you? Taste the freshness. It's delicious here. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
We're back. There's our live quad cam shot. You can see those clouds moving quite briskly there across the top, and it's going to continue throughout the day. But the only lift it is affecting is, actually, King Pine and Timberline, right?
No, just King Pine right now.
Just King Pine right now. The direction of the wind is conducive. King Pine on wind hold, but everything else is running here. And as we spoke with Roddy this morning, Skyline's looking pretty good for now, so that's good news. You definitely want to dress for it today, goggles, and it's a mitten day for sure, layer up. And joining us here this morning is Ann Twitchell from the Irregular. Everyone knows about the Irregular, and you are celebrating a big anniversary. I'd like to welcome you, Ann. How are you?
I'm doing well.
Thanks for being here this morning.
Thank you for having me.
Did you grow up reading the Irregular?
I did. My favorite feature was always the question of the week.
Yeah.
And to look through and see if there's anybody that I recognized.
I do that too.
And then I have five brothers, so we made up a whole feature ourselves one time.
Really?
Yep, they came and asked the whole set of us kids the question.
Oh, so you're well protected with five brothers. Holy smokes. Hopefully. Now, so it's the sixth decade, correct?
Yep. We're going into our sixth decade with the Irregular.
Yeah.
So.
And of course, there have been some changes. Let's talk about the schedule.
So we are currently publishing twice a month. It's not an every other week schedule. It's the second and fourth Wednesdays. So in January, where we had five Wednesdays,
right,
we had a little bit of confusion there. It's a little confusing for us too, to adjust to that.
Yeah.
We had to change the scheduling because we had some decline in the number of advertisers. Those numbers were going down, and then the cost of printing and the cost of newsprint went up. So we had to change to a twice monthly schedule.
Right.
So it's the second and fourth Wednesdays. And, you know, the Irregular has been slightly irregular. So it's we adapt to the circumstances, and
right,
at some point we may go back to a weekly.
Well, that was my question.
For the moment, it's going to be twice a month. So.
You know, it's not, I just watched a report on another small town newspaper, and I think everybody is pretty much in the same boat. It's changed, but let's hope, you know, we've relied on that for great information for so long. We don't want to ever lose it, so we're glad that you're adapting. Now, let's talk about how the newspaper kind of compares to other social media. What is your place in it, and where do you see it?
There is, so with the rise of social media, the paper has started, you know, we post stories to our website. So all the stories that go in the paper also go on the website. And then with our change in publishing, we put additional stories on the website that don't make it into a paper.
Right.
And those are for free access. But we also share those stories to social media to get communication out there. But I think that a print paper is still very important to have that information collected in one place. You know, I think that's really important.
Mm-hmm.
When I first started, I started in July last year, and in my first month, Marcia White, I was talking with her about the Carabasset Summer Camp, and when she heard I was from the Irregular, she grabbed me and she said, "The Irregular had better not go anywhere. That's like the local Bible.
Right, right.
That's where you go to find anything."
Right.
And that was, I had no idea that, well, I had some idea, but it was still really, it was really cool to see that, how other people interact with
how
it.
Passionate they are.
You know, how enthusiastic they are.
Yeah, for sure. So. Hey, stay with us. We're going to talk more with Ann Twitchell from the Irregular, and we'll be right back, and don't go away.
The WSKI TV 17 Weather Report is brought to you by the Widowmaker. Find them upstairs in the base lodge.
Good morning, all you skiers, riders, and shredders out there, and this is your morning weather update brought to you by WSKITV.com, Channel 17, and sponsored by the Widowmaker upstairs at the Base Lodge. Wednesday, today, we're looking at a partly sunny day. Temperatures at summit around 5 to 9 degrees with winds 30 to 45, gusting up to 60, so expect some wind hold today, and first person to T3 wins. On Thursday, we're looking at a very, very, very cold day, negative 8 to negative 4 at the summit with winds 25 to 40, gusting to 55. So definitely bundle up tomorrow, and it'll be a great morning to stay home and watch to win on Channel 17. On Friday, your extended forecast. We're looking partly sunny, 15 at the base, 7 at the top. On Saturday, mostly sunny, 28 at the base, 14 at the top. And Sunday, 31 at the base, 17 at the top. So your extended forecast, not too bad at all. It is going to be a little breezy, though. Your Birchwood Interior Trail Report for Wednesday. We're looking at 149 trails out there. 12 lifts getting you there, 50 of them were groomed up to near perfection, and in the last 24 hours, we had 7 inches of snow, so remember, cat skiing, make reservations, and Bracket Basin is open, but be careful. Central Mountain Grooming, we've got Timberline, Bridle Chain, Tote Road, Haywire, King's Landing, Spurline, Hayburner, White Nitro, Narrow Gauge, Comp Hill, Sluice, Lower Winter Way, Candyside, Boardwalk, Landings, Birches, and Snowbrook to get you up from the condos. On the east side, you've got Hallback, Ramdown, Boomauger. A little lower on the mountain, you've got Two Hall, Whiffletree, Cruiser, Slasher, Rollaway. On the west side, Scoot, Horseshoe, West Mountain, and Good Chance. And the Dropline Terrain Park was newly rebuilt, so check that out. At 8 o'clock, you got Snubber coming up from the condos. 8:30, you got Sawduster and Skidway. And 9 o'clock, Muscalator. At 8:30, you've got Double Runner East. 9 o'clock, Double Runner West. That gets you a little higher on the mountain. And West Mountain, 8 o'clock, gets you up to go to the Super Quad. And 8:30, you got Super Quad and Skyline to get you higher up on the mountain. King Pine and Whiffletree, 8:30. King Pine's more advanced terrain. Whiffletree is a little easier terrain. And Timberline and 3T. Is 9 o'clock. Timberline most likely will probably be on hold. Your current outdoor cross-country skiing conditions is looking really good, but the ice rink is closed due to snow, but they are going to try to get that back open soon. And Fat Biking, Narrow Gauge, and on the outdoor center, please give the groomers and snowshoers a little bit of time to help get that trail back up and running. And if you're looking to volunteer, please stop by and help out with snowshoes. Vacation week, tonight, we've got Snowshoe Safari at the Outdoor Center and at the hotel, game night and movie night. You can find all that out at sugarloaf.com. And don't forget, Thursday, watch to win. Thursday, Friday, and Saturday is watch and win, 7:30 in the morning until 9 a.m. and 5:30 to 7. And don't forget, we have live shows every day, 7:30 to 9, And you can find all this out plus much, much more on WSKITV.com. Channel 17, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is where we hang out. We will see you on the mountain.
Welcome to the all-new Widowmaker. Featuring a newly renovated rooftop deck. All-new menu and upgrade dining options. Home of the Sugarloaf Mosaic. 20 main brewed beers on tap. Visit Sugarloaf's premier nightlife and music venue today. Sugarloaf.com.
All right, we're back, and there's our live quad cam shot. And Captain Kip, the enthusiastic Captain Kip, you just got a face shot with powder. Is that true?
Oh, Greg, I just got the first tracks down Widowmaker. I'd say 7 inches of new snow in there. And as I look back up, the wind is blowing in my track. So don't worry, you'll get some fresh stuff. It's unbelievably good snow. It's one of the first good powder days we've had. Since the season opened. It's great skiing. There's a lot of folks coming down Ram Down now. Right. But it's outstanding skiing. Sun's coming out back and forth, so go. Really is. Great. Ram Down is groomed out, but Widowmaker certainly isn't.
Was it?
Hello. Hey, did I lose you? I'm back.
Okay. Yeah. We want to make sure you're okay. Yeah.
All right. I'm fine.
Okay. Thank you.
Freeze.
Okay. All right. We appreciate it.
You could just hear that. That's the report right there. He is loving it. And hopefully you'll get out and have a chance. He'll save some powder. As he said, it's blowing back in, so you'll get some of that too. Ann Twitchell is with us from The Irregular. And we've been talking about The Irregular, how it comes twice a month. And tell us when those dates are again.
So that's the second and fourth Wednesdays.
Second and fourth. Like a payday, it's twice a month.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Think of it like that. Now, you have an online presence, too. How can we support The Irregular?
Advertiser numbers are very good. So those are very important.
Sure.
And then subscriptions. You can do a print subscription, you can do an online subscription, you can do a print and online subscription. Mm-hmm. And that is, then you get the paper and it helps us stick around.
Yeah, you can read it like this instead of like this.
Right, right.
But some, to each
whatever,
their own.
Whatever you want.
Yeah, you covered both the bases.
Right.
I think local content and local politics are really important. You cover a lot, and you have some other publications. I don't know how you get the information, but I'll tell you what, The Whiteout is one of them. Do you have others as well?
So there's The Whiteout and The Snowmobile Guide, and then there's two guides that come out in the summer that I'm not remembering the names of. Mm-hmm. So we do 4 seasonal guides.
Yeah. And you collect a lot of information. I don't know
we
where
do.
You get it, but
we
it's
do.
a great resource. And you can buy the paper just about everywhere.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
And you can stop by the office
yep,
too.
You yep. You can.
And we love The Irregular, and we appreciate you coming on and sharing all the great things about The Irregular and celebrating your sixth decade. So your job is reporter?
I am the reporter, yes.
So you must get to meet a lot of people.
I get to meet so many people.
Yeah.
I get to go all over the place. Yeah. I cover from Kingfield all the way up to the Canadian border through Cobourne Gore, and then over to Strong, and then all the way up to Rangeley and past Rangeley.
Yeah.
So I went with my little brother. I stole him for the afternoon, and we went leaf peeping back in late September.
Yeah.
And we did the whole area. It's just over 200 miles.
That's great.
On the main roads.
Yeah.
That was a really fun day.
Right. Well, we look forward to reading your articles. And do you have any hot stories that you can tell us? Any scoops you can share with us this morning?
I just covered the Saddleback Party Sunday.
Yeah.
And I'm not sure if that will go online or if that'll go in the paper, but I've been covering that whole journey.
since I started in July.
And it's really happening.
And yep, it's really happening. And that whole area is just so excited. And sure. I am so excited for them. This
They've
is
been
huge.
Disappointed many times.
So yes, they have. And so this coming through has been huge.
Oh, so that's great. So look for that in the upcoming edition of the Sugarloaf or Sugarloaf, the Irregular Online. And you can pick it up at a fine establishment near you. Thank you so much for joining
us. Thank
you. A pleasure to meet you, Anne, and thank you. Keep up the great work. And to all the staff at the Irregular, we appreciate it. We'll take a break, and we'll be right back with more here on the Mountain Report.
The 1901 original state flag of Maine, from 1901 to 1909. In addition to this flag, we make U.S. flags, and so we thought with the revised interest in the 1901 version of the flag that we would make that as well. We also created our own version of the flag design, and we put it on t-shirts, baseball hats, including our quintessential Maine hat. It has the original state flag emblem on it, but it also repels black flies and mosquitoes. It's perfect for the state of Maine.
Joe here, welcome to the Shipyard Brewhouse. A fun, friendly Sugarloaf spot. Fresh food prepared with care, from modern cuisine to hearty ski comfort. Ski in, ski out, right down here on the birches. Relax and warm up by the fire. Enjoy a wide range of beers brewed right here in Maine. Enjoy Finder, a New England-style IPA, or the classic Export Ale. Come on in with family and friends. Enjoy a day of Sugarloaf spirit at the Shipyard Brewhouse.
It's Captain Kip, and I'm out here in the woods. This is weekend warm-up. I'm checking out of bounds. And don't forget, between 7:30 and 8 o'clock will be my first tracks report. We'll see you at 7:30 tomorrow morning. Oh, it's really snowing. Big flakes.
This is The Life.
This is Our Life.
Make it your life.
Visit Mountainside Real Estate in the Village at the base of the mountain.
Sugarloaf's exclusive real estate agency.
And we've got the latest information for you here on the Mountain Report, WSKI-TV. King Pine is now open. King Pine is now turning. As far as Timberline goes, well, we don't know yet, and we won't know till 9 o'clock. So that's hopeful. King Pine is open now, and we're looking pretty good. We've got some fresh snow. You could sense the excitement of Captain Kip and him out there enjoying that fresh 7 inches of powder. So get out there and enjoy that. And we'll hope that Timberline opens as well. It is, of course, breezy as it oftentimes is. It's after a snow. We have got some great snow for you, and we have got some lifts open for you, some flurries coming down. So life is good here at Sugarloaf. Glad you're with us. Enjoy all these great activities that are available for you today, for you and the family. Get out and enjoy it. And don't forget, it's the entertainment, Apres Entertainment at the Widowmaker today, so you can stop on by there. And some great family things to do today, as we had already lined out. And I do want to remind you of the Teton Gravity Research Film at the Alphonse Competition Center at 6 p.m. There will be a fee for that, but boy, that'll be a great movie on the big screen there. And Discover a CVA happens today at 3 p.m. Go and find out. If you have some questions, go on down there. You maybe have a chance to talk with some students as well and find out more about things that are happening. 3:30, they'll be off the wall juggling on Main Street. Family game night at the hotel at 4 till 6. Family movie night at the hotel at 6 o'clock. The Steve Jones Duo, 3 to 6, all ages welcome, and no cover. And that is at the Widowmaker Try.
No weather, just quick break.
Oh, all right, we'll take a quick break. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.
Check out WSKITV.com on all your mobile devices. Local mountain and lakes forecast, dozens of videos of things to do, everyone a reason to stay another day. Know before you go with WSKI TV 17 and WSKITV.com.
Located in Village West, the Sugarloafer Shop supports the iconic Sugarloaf Triangle that is one of the most recognizable logos in the world. Founded on the traditional logo t-shirt and now offering everything from high-end fashion items, home decor, and logo hats, to bathing suits, children's clothes, Under Armour product lines, and original artwork and photography by local artists, the Sugarloafer Shop is your one stop for everything logo wear. Stop in and grab some loaf gear today.
Know about the local weather before you head out? Want to find out about another cool place to discover? Want to see and hear from those who know what's happening in the Maine High Peaks? WSKI TV 17 is the number one rated TV station year after year because we are your source of info on everything to see, do, and love throughout the greater Maine High Peaks region. Tune in daily to the Mountain Report, Explore, and more, such as From the Archives, during our local programming, 7:30 to 11 a.m., 11:30 to 1 o'clock midday, and 5 to 7 p.m. And no before you go, only with WSKI.
There it is, the beach shot. Looking pretty busy out there. Get out and enjoy it today. King Pine is open today. It's running. We don't know about Timberline yet, but it's scheduled to run. So that's the latest information. That's just about going to wrap it up for this edition of the Mountain Report. All week long, live shows. So whether you're watching online or watching right here locally on Channel 17, we thank you very much for watching here this morning. Don't forget, tomorrow morning begins, yes, Watch and Win. Thursday morning, we'll start it up on Thursday morning. So hopefully you will tune in and have a chance to win the Joe James rugs and more. So until tomorrow, thank you so much on behalf of all of us here at Snowfields Productions. Thanks for choosing Sugarloaf is your destination location. Have fun. Enjoy the fresh snow.